द अपलिएंट एंड द रेस्पोंडेंट एंटर्ड इनटू एन एग्रीमेंट फॉर सेल ऑफ द प्रॉपर्टी इन डिस्प्यूट ऑन 21 December 2005 फॉर अ सम ऑफ रुपीज 6 lakh इन विच एन एडवांस ऑफ रुपीज 2 lakh वॉज पेड टू द रेस्पोंडेंट एट द टाइम ऑफ एग्जीक्यूटिंग द एग्रीमेंट फॉर सेल फुल स्टॉप. वन ऑफ द स्टिपुलेशन इन द एग्रीमेंट फॉर सेल वॉज दैट द बैलेंस अमाउंट ऑफ द कंसिडरेशन मनी शैल बी पेड टू द रेस्पोंडेंट एट द टाइम ऑफ रजिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ द सेल डीड कॉमा विच शैल बी एग्जीक्यूटेड विद इन 60 days from the date of execution of the agreement for sale full stop. The agreement for sale specifically mentioned that it was the obligation of the respondent to keep the title good till the execution and registration of the sale deed and further to keep the property in dispute free from all encumbrance or charges full stop. Para. It was also agreed that the respondent shall pay all rates, taxes and cesses in regard to the property in dispute up to the date of sale and all dues prior to the sale deed full stop. It was further agreed that in case of dispute, the same should be referred to arbitration under the provisions of Arbitration and Conciliation Act, 1996, full stop. The respondent borrowed funds from KSDC and various other financial institutions for installation of various kinds of machineries in the factory, thereby created equitable mortgage by way of deposit of title deeds with various financial institutions full stop. It was clearly understood that at the time of registration of the sale deed, vacant and peaceful physical possession of property in dispute would be delivered by the respondent to the appellant and that the respondent would be bound to remove all plants and machineries from their factory in order to deliver possession to the appellant after clearing all its dues to the various financial institutions and keep the title deed ready full stop para. For the purpose of execution of the sale deed, the appellant started doubting its bona fide and, therefore, by a letter notice dated 18th of February 2006 called upon the respondent to execute the sale deed so that the vacant possession of the property in dispute could be delivered to him full stop. On 20th of February 2006, the appellant received a letter from the respondent asking him to complete the sale transaction on the very next day, that is on 21st of February 2006 full stop. After the receipt of the letter mentioned above, the appellant approached the respondent and requested the respondent to perform their part of the obligation full stop. The respondent assured the appellant that they would require some more time to remove the machineries from the property in dispute as they were in large numbers and very huge in size full stop. They also informed the appellant that they required some more time to make alternative arrangement of other premises where their plants and machineries could be kept as they were very expensive and involved a lot of money full stop. As the appellant had already paid an amount of rupees 2 lakh to the respondent, he had no choice but to keep quiet full stop.